I saw him only yesterday, before he's 45, with the minuscule force of his index finger, blue brains and blood around a neat hole in the plywood wall. I saw him there today, with hair combed down and face intact. Still, I did not know him. A young boy lay near, with an almost smile, appearing nearly alive, but for his bloodless eyes and his lack of legs. God knows where he left them. I thought, as I drank a cold beer from the cooler meant to preserve the flesh, body bags, ham sandwiches, of that dog I remember, that auto-maimed dog who lay howling on the asphalt, whose pain and fear and anger I ended with a bludgeoning axe, to ease my own hurt. I saw life in his misery, but where the hell is death? All that's left is meat, body bags, grave markers, fields and green fields of white, strictly aligned markers. Even the army can have a poetic sense. Graves can be counted, named, dressed, and touched, but death will not register.